Very good morning, everyone. I will be presenting from the Department of Clinical Nutrition my abstract entitled 4 weeks of aerobic and resistant exercise improves frailty in patients with liver cirrhosis, a liver rehabilitation center outcome data. So frailty is a state of reduced physiological reserve which associated with increased vulnerability to health stressors, increasing physical dependency, and multiple adverse outcomes, including death, not only in patients in older patients, but also in patients with chronic liver disease, chronic kidney disease, and cancer. And it accelerates the progression of physical dysfunction and muscle atrophy, regardless of age. Liver cirrhosis is characterized by muscle wasting, malnutrition, and functional decline. Frailty, which is a spectrum ranging from mild deconditioning to failure to thrive, is seen in around 17 to 43% of patients with liver cirrhosis, associated with poor quality of life, depression, resilience, worsening disability, disease progression, unplanned hospitalizations, and death. So there is interdependence between physical fitness, nutritional status, and liver cirrhosis. Fatigue and decreased exercising capacity with low cardiopulmonary endurance leads to decreased exercise and which leads to functional deterioration. On the other hand, poor nutritional status, especially in the form of sarcopenia, adds to this functional deterioration, leading to frailty and finally succumbing to death. So there are various ways to measure frailty. Certain are composite scores such as frailty index, short physical performance battery, and liver frailty index. Certain individual tests such as 6-minute walk test and gait speed were also used to measure frailty in patients with liver cirrhosis. In literature, various programs ranging from 8 to 12 weeks of aerobic exercise have shown improvement in the bone density, in the muscle mass and strength, overall quality of life, cardiopulmonary endurance, and reduction in the liver pressure in patients with liver cirrhosis. So basically, it is a continuum of education, adequate nutrition, and exercise throughout the disease course. And the complexity of the exercise should be adjusted as per the disease severity as well as the complications at the time of evaluation with the help of a multidisciplinary team. With this background, we aim to evaluate the effect of structured exercise and nutritional program on liver frailty index, henceforth termed as LFI, and physical performance in cirrhotics. So our primary objective was to measure the change in performance parameters and LFI score before and after 4 weeks of liver rehabilitation program, henceforth termed as LHP, in patients with liver cirrhosis. Secondary objectives were to assess adverse events during LHP, evaluate any weight change or improvement in nutritional status of nutritional intake after 4 weeks of LHP. It is a prospective study including diagnosed patients of liver cirrhosis, majority them being outpatients, referred to rehab center for monitored exercise and nutrition program between 2019 and 2020. So all the patients underwent details of clinical parameters such as disease severity, comorbidities and medications, physical limitations, and cardiopulmonary status. Their performance parameters were 6-minute walk test and gait speed were recorded. A nutritional intake in the form of 24-hour recall and food frequency questionnaire was taken. So liver frailty index was calculated using 3 parameters, grip strength, chair stance, and balance. Hand grip strength was calculated in both the dominant as well as non-dominant hands using dynamometer. Patients were made to sit on a comfortable chair without rest, and they were made to hold their hands on their shoulder, and 5 chair stands were duration at which they can perform 5 chair stands were noted. Balance was done in 3 different positions. One is side to side, and another is semi-tandem, and another is tandem position, each lasting for 10 seconds. The duration for which the patient can balance is noted down. All these values are put in an online calculator, which gives us an unitless value of liver frailty index. Further, it is classified as robust if the value is less than 3.2, pre-frail between 3.3 to 4.5, and frail if it is more than 4.5. All these data were recorded in a structured performer. Informed consent was taken. All the assessment was repeated at the end of each session at 4 weeks. So what is LEHAP program? It consists of 4 weeks of 8 sessions of supervised exercise, 2 sessions per week supervised by a physiotherapist, and at least 3 sessions a week of self-monitored exercise at home. A diet comprising of 20 to 30 kilocalories and 1.2 to 1.5 gram per kg of protein were prescribed as 6 divided meals, including a pre-exercise and a late evening protein supplement. So the exercise program mainly consisting of 3 sets of exercises: aerobic, resistant, and stretching and balance exercises. The intensity was tested by talk test, that is, patient should be able to complete a sentence during his exercise, and a box scale of 3 to 5 was taken. The exercise regimen was adjusted according to the disease state and physical capacity of the patient. The paired continuous variables pre and post intervention were tested by paired T test, and the paired categorical variables were tested through McNamara test. So out of 96 patients, 79 patients were pre-frail, around 15% were frail, and only 6% were robust. Around 66 patients could complete their LEHAP program, and 100% compliance was seen in them and hence taken for pre-post analysis. So coming to the baseline characteristic, patients, the mean age of patients were around 56 years, majority of being males and majority belonging to the child A category, and majority belonging to NASH related cirrhosis. So regarding their activity, majority of them were independent in their activity. However, they followed a sedentary lifestyle. The mean energy intake was around 1600 calories and mean protein intake was around 60 gram. So the average BMI was around 27, which is towards the obesity. So coming to my primary objective, the liver frailty index as absolute value improved by 0.3 unit, that is 6%. 6-minute walk test improved by 34 meters. Gait speed improved by 0.1 meter per second at the end of 4 weeks, which was statistically significant. Category-wise, 12 patients, that is 19 patients improved category-wise, that is 8 become robust from pre-frail and 4 become pre-frail from frail. So there were no adverse events of the LHPs noted. No significant change in body weight was seen. However, protein intake increased by 13 gram, which was statistically significant. So to conclude, a structured exercise program is acceptable and feasible in cirrhotic patients. 4 weeks of monitored exercise and nutrition program improves frailty, muscle strength, and physical performance and protein intake in these patients and is recommended for routine intervention. Long-term compliance, effect on body composition, effect on clinical outcomes need further randomization control trials. Thank you.